for the configuration of this internet program. So the title of tonight's talk is Transformation in Christ. And following this talk, we will have our dedication ceremony. As we all know, that all of you are all ready and excited to join us in our community of Couples for Christ. So we also could not wait to welcome you, brothers and sisters. So that think without further delay, may I invite everyone to stand up for the opening prayer. Let's put ourselves in the presence of the Lord. All together, sign ourselves in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Allow me to read to you, brothers and sisters, the Holy Gospel of Jesus Christ according to St. Matthew, chapter 10, verses 24 to 33. Jesus said to his apostles, "No disciple is above his teacher, no slave above his master. It is enough for the disciple that he become like his teacher, for the slave that he become like his master. If they have called the master of the house Beelzebul, how much more those of his household? Therefore, do not be afraid of them. Nothing is concealed that will not be revealed, nor secret that will not be known. What I say to you in the darkness, speak in the light. What you hear whispered, proclaim on the housetops. And do not be afraid of those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Rather, be afraid of the one who can destroy both soul and body in Gehenna. Are not two sparrows sold for a small coin? Yet not one of them falls to the ground without your Father's knowledge. Even all the hairs of your head are counted. So do not be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. Everyone who acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge before my Heavenly Father. But whoever denies me before others, I will deny before my Heavenly Father." Brothers and sisters, message from the Lord. Father in Heaven, we praise and thank you tonight for gathering each and every one of us here in this place. Thank you for giving us this wonderful venue for the continuation of this missionary program. Father in Heaven, we also would like to thank you for so many wonderful blessings that you have been giving each and every one of us, for all the challenges, the trials that make us strong, Father in Heaven, and that allow us to continue to recognize you as our God, to recognize your power and might, Father in Heaven. Thank you, Father in Heaven, for surrounding us with so many wonderful friends, newfound friends and brothers and sisters, whom you have called by name, Father in Heaven, to be part of this community, to be part of Couples for Christ. Father in Heaven, tonight as we gather here, we welcome your presence, Father in Heaven, into this place. Protect this place, Father in Heaven, with your holy presence, and fill each and every one of us, Father in Heaven, with love, joy, and peace as we continue to celebrate the completion of this Christian Life program. Father in Heaven, allow us to offer you our praise song tonight, One Way, Jesus. Thank you. Father in heaven, for allowing us, Father in heaven, to shout, allowing us, Lord, to clap our hands, to dance and to sing for you, Father in heaven. Thank you for the talents, thank you for the time, thank you, Lord, for the life, the health, the safety that you have given us, Father in heaven. Thank you for this wonderful community, for all our leaders, Father in heaven. We thank you. Thank you, Father in heaven, also for the gift of life, for the gift of our family, our spouses, for the gift of our children, Father in heaven, that you have blessed each and every one of us. Thank you, Father in heaven, for your unfailing love, despite of our weaknesses, despite of our trespasses, Father in heaven. Thank you, Father in heaven, for always being with us every step of our way. Father in heaven, as we continue to live our life, we will continue to face trials, because trials make us strong, make us recognize you, Father in heaven, our life. We lift up to you all our concerns, Father in heaven. Whatever worry, whatever burden we have right now, just bothering us, just stopping us, Father in heaven, to come closer to you. We'd like to lift up to you, Father in heaven, our brothers and sisters who are suffering right now, those who are in pain, those who are losing jobs, those who are sick, Father in heaven, those seeking your attention, we lift them up to you, Father in heaven. Also, we'd like to lift up to you all our loved ones whom we may have left behind in our service to you, Father. May you protect each and every one of us, including all our loved ones here in Singapore and other parts of the world, Father in heaven. Allow us, Lord, to feel you each hour of the day. Allow us, Lord, to see you each time to seek for you, Father in heaven. Father in heaven, allow us to offer to you this worship song, I give my all.
Yeah.
the rest of the night. We talk to you, our speaker tonight, who's going to deliver your message, going to impart your words, Father in Heaven, in front of all these wonderful friends, wonderful participants we have in this Christian Life program. Protect our speaker, Father in Heaven, and may your voice be his voice throughout his talk tonight. We also protect each and every one of us who are here in this place, Father in Heaven. May you open our hearts and our minds and allow each and every one of us, Father in Heaven, to focus on you alone, to appreciate all the messages that we're going to be blessed tonight. All our concerns, our worries, we lift up to you. In the name of Jesus, your Son who lives and reigns with you in heaven, with the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, and now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Good evening,
brothers and sisters.
Good evening.
So before we continue our talk tonight, allow me to just go through a very quick one of what we had last week. Talk together and the life and mission of Hope for Christ. Hope for Christ is a Christian family renewal ministry that started in June 1981 in Manila, Philippines. Our call is to bring families back to the plan of God. TFC is to renew, strengthen, and support Christian families. Our mission is to bring glad tidings to the poor. We believe that marriage is indissoluble. It is meant for love between man and woman, and for the procreation of children. God created man and wife with equal personal worth and dignity, and with their respective roles in family. Parents have the right and responsibility to educate their children. The Christian family shares with the life and mission of the church through prayers, evangelization, and service to others, especially the poor. Christian family renewal can best be achieved by inviting Jesus to be the Lord of our hope, by tapping the power of the Holy Spirit, and through the full use of all spiritual gifts at our disposal. We support one another in CFC. Can you feel that, brothers and sisters? The support from, especially for your DGL, for the past these 13 weeks. And that is not the end. Today is only the beginning for all of us. We are committed relationships through cell groups, households, by ongoing teaching and formation, and by other regular activities. During then, our discussion was, do you agree with the CFC statement of philosophy, which embodies beliefs and ideals? Do you see the covenant of CFC as the ideal of Christian family life that God calls us all to? And the challenge to all of us, brothers and sisters, God is trying to restore the Christian family back to his original plan. And we are all called to respond to his divine effort and be a part of his work. Are you ready to do your share in renewing, strengthening, and supporting Christian family living? So are we all ready, brothers and sisters? Are we all renewed after the past 13 weeks of coming into this place? I can't see anyone. Some are smiling, but nobody is saying yes, I'm renewed. So brothers and sisters, we, of course, believe that we have been touched and blessed in many ways. for some of us are too shy to express it. But God is listening, you know, to your heart. Not for the voice, but He's listening to what is in our heart. And I can feel that, brothers and sisters. So tonight, allow me to just briefly introduce to you our speaker. Our speaker tonight is one of our national council leaders. He's been so faithful in this community that he brings his entire family in active service in the Compost for Christ community. And I can't remember exactly how many years he's been in the community. I think he's sitting around 15 years. And I will allow him to describe himself more. So instead of talking about all his achievements. So without further ado, allow me to call on our brother, Rolly Una.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. Can you hear me clearly?
Yes.
Thank you. So I was trying to use the louder mic. My voice is loud, but I like a louder mic because you might sleep while I talk. Anyway, my name is Rolly, and I'm here to give you the last talk. Thank heaven. Many of you probably will say, thank heavens, it's the last talk. You know, probably when you were sitting there the first day that you were invited here, and somebody said, we're going to have 12 talks. Every Saturday you have to come here. Oh my God. I can't believe that you have invited us to come here for 12 consecutive Saturdays. But before you know it, this is our last Saturday. Right? Surprising. Okay, so I think my talk is not yet here. I have to look for it. Just give me a short one. Okay, as Brother Mandy was saying, I have been a long-time member of Compost for Christ. We started in CLC way back in 1991 in Manila. So many call us, I mean, old folks like us, they call us the Jurassic here in Compost for Christ. So, but I'd like to, even before we start, I'd like to introduce to you my lovely wife of 33 years. And she's there at the back. There, the one with a very long hair. Okay, so, you know, Compost for Christ has been doing this for the longest time. And if you will notice, there's really nothing different from what you normally hear from the priest. Am I correct or not? Or you're not listening to the priest? Actually, the Christian Life Program is just giving you a better perspective of what our priests are telling us every Sunday in church. It gives us a different perspective of how we look at Christianity. And in fact, nothing has deviated from what the Catholic Church has actually taught us. If you will remember, the first module that we talked about was the basic truths of Christianity. So we're not deviating from anything there. Okay? And we were taught actually of all of the dogmas of the church. Okay, that we are to believe on the dogmas of the church. But there is one thing very important that was taught us in the first module, and that was our repentance. That's our transformation. We went to the second module, and we were talking about the authentic Christian life. Okay, we were taught how we are supposed to live as a true Christian, knowing the Holy Spirit and how the Holy Spirit can actually help us. Most of the time, and me, I graduated from a Catholic school in Manila, but I never really realized that the Holy Spirit is a powerful support to our Christian faith. And finally, this last module, we're talking about living a life of a Spirit-filled life in the Holy Spirit. So basically, brothers and sisters, this is the last talk. And as Brother Mandy was saying, this is not really the last talk. This is just a beginning. It's a beginning of something which is more exciting than the end of this CLP. And that is a whole new life with God and with your newfound friends. Okay? So who are your newfound friends here? So, most of the time, your newfound friends will be your group, right? You have probably started having a bond amongst yourselves. In fact, one of the problems that we have normally in this Corpus for Christ, or the community per se, is when we start disbanding that group. Most of the time says, oh no, please don't transfer us to another household. Okay? But you will learn through time why we normally do this. Okay? So probably if you are, well, Brother Mandy is saying, we are excited to invite you and hope you are also excited to join us. Basically, for the first year, we will group you into households, and then you will end up having your own regular meetings within your own household. That's why you will pay so much of a bond that most of the time nobody wants to let go. Okay? But you will learn through time why it is important that you should let go. So, brothers and sisters, if you notice that throughout the CLP, the Lord has laid the foundation for this new life. Okay? He has laid out the foundation. You have to looking at what these foundations are. So, number one, it's your repentance. Okay? Remember that repentance leads us to transformation. You will never be transformed if you do not repent. Okay? So, brothers and sisters, you probably will ask me, but God, I do not have any sin. That's good. If you are sinless, then that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. Okay? But I think you better assess yourself if you really don't have a sin. Okay? But once you realize that you are ready to repent, then that's where the transformation starts. Okay? Now we will have his personal conversion and of course an renewed faith in God. So, it's important that we have to understand that this renewed faith in God will come from your acceptance of Jesus as the Lord and Savior. Excuse me, I just dropped something. Okay, so, top number four about repentance and faith tells us about, really, this is a double action thing. You know, that we cannot be repenting and we cannot be believing. We cannot be repenting at the same time believing Christ. on the other hand, we cannot just be believing in Christ. What am I saying? or you can be repenting, but at the same time, you don't believe that Christ is our Savior. Okay? Christ is our Savior. Now, if you ask me, what are we really trying to do here? Okay? And brothers and sisters, this is just part of the great plan of God. That all of us, we're doing this is because we want to go where? We want to go where? Well, there. That's right. At the end of time, we want to go to heaven. That's right. Because that is where God wants us. He wants us at the end of time to all come back to Him. And that's why we are actually getting everybody, we're reminding everybody that we have to repent, to transform, so we are able to go back to our Lord. So basically, our God has taught us that the way is Jesus. That's why the Bible says that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. I hope by this time, you now find meaning in these words. Okay? That Jesus is the way. God said, I'm going to give you yours, my son. He is the way. Follow Him. Okay? But most of us really do not really understand what that means. That was very clearly said in our talk number 4. That when you are repenting, repentance is not just turning away from sin, but what? Talk number 4 said, it's a complete obedience to God. Oh, that is really very hard. Complete obedience to God. Okay? So, He is the way, now the truth. Why the truth? Because everything that is written about the Lord, about Jesus, everything that is written in the Bible is actually the truth. Find something there that is not telling us differently. Find something in the Bible that will not lead you to salvation. Probably the story of Judas when he hung himself, right? But most of the time, all of the teachings in the Bible teaches us how to live our life. And finally, He is the light. Because I don't know, brothers and sisters, for the past many years that we have been in this community, we had a very joyous life. I'm not saying that we are always with money. We had so many difficulties. We had our own trials. You know, but our life has been very, very joyful. We have been in this community for the past 23 years. And truly, when my wife first told me, when we were about one or two years after the CLP, Mommy said, Rolly, I think I'm going to retire from work. That time, we just borrowed money to build the house in Manila. So she said, I'm going to retire. I said, why are you going to retire? Because, you know, see, the Christian, the Homes for Christ is teaching us how to take care of our children, how to build our life. And if I will not be with our children, it is so difficult. You know, when she told that to me, you know, I was like scratching my head. How can we make this money choosing the path that we know? You know, but at the end of the day, we sat down, we prayed, and we start computing. I told Mami, it will be very difficult. But that faith in God, you know, allowed us to move forward. And she did. You know, the Lord is very faithful. A few months or even a year that she retired, she was offered to do something by the company where she retired. And she was able to be with our children and at the same time to be earning money. So the Lord keeps you going. I tell you, brothers and sisters, There's so many stories that we can tell you, and this whole evening might not be enough. But sometimes you will be awed and surprised how the Lord has always been faithful to those that remain faithful to Him. Okay, brothers and sisters, keep that in mind. The Lord will remain faithful to all those who remain faithful to Him. Okay? So don't just pray, brothers and sisters, because like for instance, you're looking for a new position in the company. Lord, there is a new position. Please give me that. Okay? But you have not been thanking the Lord for all your blessings. Most of the time, that's how we pray. Most of the time, that's how we ask the Lord. When we need something, we pray. When we have a problem, we pray. But most of the time, we forget that when we are happy, when we are not sick, when we wake up every morning, when your boyfriend or girlfriend calls you in the middle of the night to say that I'm okay and I miss you, those are the things that you say, I love you, Lord. Thank you for all of these blessings. Thank the Lord. I tell you, thank the Lord more and He will give you more. Ask Him more and He will not give you anything. I think that has been what has happened for life in many, many years. Use the power of the Holy Spirit. You have been empowered. It will be a pity if you don't ask that power to be with you. If you remember, what is this empowerment? This comes in the form of gifts, brothers and sisters. If you do not remember those gifts, you go back to the reading. And He'll tell you that it's about knowledge. It's about understanding what you're reading. It's about healing. Creating miracles. It's about discerning what you are making. Okay? It's about faith. These are manifestations that you know that the Holy Spirit is in your heart. But keep in mind, brothers and sisters, the Holy Spirit cannot come in if there are many devils there. Okay? What are these little devils? Are anger, are hatred, are envy. Our desires, men are lustful desires. This has to all go because the Holy Spirit cannot come if you don't let it go. And finally, the continuing support you will receive is your faith. You know, brothers and sisters, if you told me when I was young, you will be surprised that how I became like this. In fact, I was telling a story last night. I had a very long time supplier when I was still working in the Philippines. And you know, when you are a supplier, when you have a supplier, sometimes he'll invite you to go out, to drink, to do many things. So he knows my life. One time, I was we went to Vancouver, and we were asked, because I also have a former member there that said, "Hey, Rolly, You're coming here to Vancouver, can you give us a talk?" So, okay, no problem. So I was there, and then from afar, I saw this fellow coming. And I said, "Gosh, that is Buddy." So, his name is Buddy. So when he was approaching, he looked at me. "Hey, Rolly, yes, Rolly, you are a speaker? Yes, I am your speaker." "Oh, I'll go home already." "No, why? I will not learn anything from you." Why? Because he knows my past. He knows how bad, how irresponsible I was with him. You know, but I tell you, the Christian Life program has helped me. And I owe my life to the first household head that I had. You know, but he died already. Not because he has having a difficult time transforming us. No, that's not how he died. Well, he had a weak heart, so he died. But, you know, I can still remember him. He always calls us faithfully because we had a Friday meeting. So now, he will call me in the office, "Rolia, don't forget our meeting tonight. I have a drinking tonight." So my friendship with the boys slowly dwindled. And it was more attending our regular prayer meeting. And that's why slowly he helped me to get transformed. So the Lord has laid this foundation for this new life, to this CLP. You keep that in mind, brothers and sisters. However, allow the Lord to continue the process of your transformation. Allow Him. Because if you leave tonight here and then, oh, yay, 12 weeks gone. Now I don't need to attend that Saturday meeting. No, please, allow the Lord to completely transform your life. Because this is not just one session. You know, I'm telling you, I've been here for 23 years. Well, I'm not telling you I'm a holy man. Okay? So the Lord is still working on me. Oh, by the way, my children are not here. My children are as grown as you. So they're already all grown up. Two of them are married, and only one is not yet married. So all of them are still there, are there in the Philippines, and they have their own lives to do for this. So, the Lord desires your transformation. Keep that in mind. Okay? The Lord desires this transformation for many reasons. He has actually a purpose. But first, He wants to have that deeper relation. No? We want to have a deeper relation. He wants us to have a deeper relationship with Him. Okay, why? In the first letter of Peter, chapter 1, verses 15 to 16, this is what he said. But as He who called you is holy, be holy yourselves in every aspect of your conduct. For it is written, be holy, for I am holy. Okay? So this deeper relationship that the Lord is asking us needs our holiness. Brothers and sisters, He needs your holiness. It is not easy. It is hard to become holy. But I will give you a tip. Very simple. What is in our mind right now? Our mind says, to err is human. Right? To err is human. So meaning, it's normal for us human beings to always commit a mistake. Now, why don't you change that to, I want to be holy. So your mind said, no. Instead of, to have this human, put in your mind, I want to be holy. So how do you do that? Every morning when you wake up, go to the mirror. Ha! Go to the mirror early morning so you wake up. And then you tell yourself, I want to be holy. Lord, good morning. I want to be holy. You know, it will change. You know, I was a... for the longest time, I am a very irritable person. And bragging aside, when I left the company in Manila, I was a high management position. And I tell you, all my subordinates with me were like fearful of me because I shout at them. I embarrassed them in front of everybody. And, you know, when I was trying to change myself, when I was invited, I did not tell anybody in the office that I was invited to the Christian Life program. 2 years after, one of my admin assistants said, sir, yes. Can I tell you something? Of course. But do not get angry, please, sir. Yeah, why will I get angry? No, I just want to tell you something. What is that? You know you don't get angry anymore. My gosh. You know when he said that, I realized that something really has changed. You know what I was doing during that time? I am waking up in the morning and I go to the mirror. I always see myself. And I tell myself, I am gentle. Every morning, I am gentle. You know, it really has helped me. Of course, sometimes you find it funny, but it helps. You know, after that, I tell you, after that, when people realize that I've changed, that was the time I started inviting them to CLP. And many in the office I was able to. I cannot invite them when I was shouting and cursing them, because they would say, my gosh, what will I learn from him? Which was my friend in Vancouver, was me. Okay? In Matthew, the Lord said, Jesus said to his disciples, whoever wishes to come after him must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. Okay? So this relationship that he wants with us, besides being holy, is discipleship. So what is a disciple? A disciple of Christ is the one who follows. Okay? We have to follow. What will we follow? Go and start reading your Bible. It's there. You know, many people are asking, how should we solve the problem in this world? You know, the truth is, there is one book that tells all the answers. Except most of the time you don't read it. And we start reading the Bible. There's just one simple thing that the Lord told us. Love everyone. Very simple. Love everyone. Do you think if we love everybody, will there be hatred and envy in this world? Maybe there will be, but there will be very small. And how, why are we having a life like this? Because, you know, the anger, the hatred, you know, it's always there. It is what? It's what's in our hearts. That's why we have to change that heart, brothers and sisters. That's why there is transformation. That is why we have to transform. Transformers. We have to be transformers, okay? Brothers and sisters, God desires your transformation. He wants to have a deeper relationship, and he wants us to have a deeper relationship with God and us. Brothers and sisters, actually it's not easy. I think it's not easy. Somebody who borrows money from you, and he doesn't pay you anymore, how can you call him a brother or a sister? My God, when will you pay me? Right? So, in the office, you have a colleague who told you your best friend, but when you were not promoted, your boss said, oh, because your friend said you don't know how to do this work. Gosh, can you forgive that? Can you still love that person? Well, it's not easy. But that's how life is, brothers and sisters. That's how you will offer your life to the Lord. Gosh, Lord, is that true? When you slap me in the right cheek, I will have to give my left cheek. Unfortunately, but you know, the Lord is very faithful. You know, I want you to reflect how the Lord really have changed your life, even if you have not been here in a Christian life already. Try to look how, what happened to your life. Sometimes you look only at the bad things that has happened. Why don't you start now assessing what were the good things that has happened in your life? Some of the things probably don't even realize it will happen to you. But it did. Okay? He wants a greater commitment of service to us. Okay? So look at all of these brothers and sisters around us. It's the service that we make for all of you. Okay? You know, brothers and sisters, it is not enough that we know Christ. It is not enough. We have to share Christ to others. Many of our friends, actually, you know, they go to church. But how deep is their relationship with us? Many of us actually are Sunday Christians. You know, many of us, we just turn and don't look when we see our friends, you know, especially men, cheating on their wives. I'm not saying that only men does that. I know women also do that. But how many of us just turn our back and don't do anything? How many of our friends got caught in a casino wasting their money, but we're not doing anything? How many of our friends got hooked in either drugs or alcohol, but we did not lift a finger to help? This is the service that the Lord wants us. And sometimes, we just say, well, this is problem. No, that's not his problem, brothers and sisters. That's all our problem. That is why the world is like this. Because we just turn our face and look to the other direction. We have to stop that. We have to first be like Christ. And in our office, show how Christ really lives in our lives. So others will follow. So when others start doing other things, sure, it's easy for you to say, right? How can you stop somebody from cheating from his wife when you yourself are cheating from your wife? How can you do? How can you do that? When I was a son in Indonesia, I told my friend, hey, you did not bring your wife here. You better be careful. And I'm going to watch you, I told him. No, I'm not going to do that. But I take it upon myself. He's not Catholic, but he's Christian. So he knows what adultery means. But if you don't say anything, if you don't lift a finger, then all brothers and sisters, when the Lord asks us when we die, did you help your friend? Lord, I did. I helped everybody. How come the other one is in hell? Oh, I forgot to tell him not to commit adultery. It's our responsibility as well, brothers and sisters. That's why we have to have a greater commitment to service. Simply, all of this, everything that we do here, is just simple. All of us want to just be back to the Lord. And it's His plan. In Ephesians, it's a plan for the fullness of times to sum up all things in Christ, in heaven and on the earth. Okay? As I said, we have to start evangelizing others. In Matthew chapter 20, verses 18 to 20, Jesus approached and said to them, all power in heaven and on earth has been given me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. Brothers and sisters, teaching them to observe. We were asked to go and teach them to observe what He has commanded us. So when we were commanded, that's why we have asked now. We are now asked to teach you as well. So when we go, it will be now your responsibility to teach others. Okay? So this does not stop here, brothers and sisters. The Christian Life Program is just the beginning. It now starts from the day, from the hour you leave tonight. Okay? So at the end of the day, we can raise our families in the Holy Spirit that will renew the faith of learning. In fact, Focus for Christ vision is families in the Holy Spirit renewing the faith of the earth. You know, brothers and sisters, we can do this. We can achieve all of this personal holiness through our daily prayer and scriptures. Okay? We should now start praying. If you're not praying every day, start. Doesn't matter. Even if it's a minute, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, but start praying. What will you pray for? Okay? If you don't know what to pray for, look at your hand. I have a very ugly hand. So look at your hand. Okay? Who do you pray for? Pray for this one. Closest to you. This is your family. Pray for your mother and father if you are not yet married. Pray for your spouse if you are married. Pray for your children. Pray for your relatives. Pray for your friends. They're close all to you. Who's this? Pray for those who teach. Pray for us. Pray for the pastors in the church, for our priests. They're the ones who teach. They're the ones who teach us. Now, who's this? This is not a dirty finger. This is not a dirty finger. This is the biggest among the fingers, right? Unless it's cut, but this is the biggest. Who are the biggest? They are the people who are in authority. They're the ones who control, for instance, the government, the banking people, the money in this world. Let's pray for them so they don't be greedy, so that they don't be corrupted. Let's pray for them. I can tell you many, many stories about prayer and how we have saved my brother, my family, so many. I tell you how my wife will pray, and he prayed for somebody else, and that fellow was looking for her for 6 months. When we were in Indonesia, somebody called her and said, I've been hunting you for the past 6 months because I want to thank you. When you prayed over me, the day before I got, before I was to be operated, that day I was found, I don't need an operation. Brothers and sisters, these very simple things, you will put it as aside. But my wife, who does not even know this fellow, prayed over him. Now this one, so difficult to put like this, no? This is actually the weakest of our fingers. You know, the doctor said, you can actually cut this and this will, you can still use your hand very well. These are actually the weak people in the world. These are the sick people that we should always be praying for. These are the weak, those that cannot fight, those that are helpless. Okay? The poor people in the streets, we pray for them. And who is this? Don't use this to pick your nose, please. This one is the leader. Leader among the five kings. And this is you. You're the least in this world, brothers and sisters. But don't forget, even if you're the least, you pray for yourself. Okay? So now you know how to pray. Okay? That 5 minutes will become 15 minutes if you start praying. Read the scriptures, I tell you. You will be surprised how the scriptures, how the Lord has written all of these promises in that book. Okay, faithfulness to the CFC covenant. Later we will give your covenant. Okay? You will have your own covenant if you desire to be part of our community. Okay, and then there will be formation programs. I tell you, this can help you. So don't worry about this. This will not be graded, you will not have a diploma after this. This will be on your own time, okay? If you can attend, attend. If you cannot attend, fine, okay? But if you have time to attend, please attend, okay? So, that's the purpose of God. We have to build our strong family and our homes, okay? Remember that the family is the basic unit of society that was done in talk number 7. Its condition will determine the condition of everything else. Okay? I don't think I need to explain that anymore. Be a light in your neighborhood. Okay? You can never invite anybody. You cannot evangelize if you cannot be seen as somebody who really follows the ways of the Lord. Okay? As I said, 2 years I did not say that I was. I have attended the Christian life group. Because in the office, know me as the devil. They know me as somebody who shouts at everyone. Okay? But after 2 years that they see my change, that was the time I said, I think I can be aligned to somebody else. Bring your children. If you're still very young, so your children are all very little, very small. But we have a program, the AMC, you bring them to the Kids for Christ. The YFC, if you have teenagers. SFC, if you have young women like that. Now, those YFC, if you are able to have your own GG, as they call it. You know what the GG is? Okay, they know. So if you have your GG, you can eventually be moved to Focus for Christ. You will be called the Young CFC. You will not join the old to run CMC like us. Yeah, because we have our different stories to tell. Okay? However, those men or women that chose, no, I'm telling you, there are those who chose to be the single blessedness. You can go to the old men ministry, which is the servants of the Lord, or the women ministry, which is the handmaids of the Lord. Okay? So it's really a womb to tomb ministry. Okay? So this is our global mission, brothers and sisters. We're inviting you. This is a big word. As the Lord said, the harvest is plenty and the laborers are few. Okay? I tell you, there are more people now in Clarke who will be drinking tonight than people who are attending this, listening to this talk. It's normal. That's how we were raised. That's how the hedonistic society has taught us. Okay? So we would rather be in Clarke than in the Blessed Sacrament Church, listening to a speaker who is already Jurassic. Okay? But that's right. But we need you, brothers and sisters. This is our global mission. Every CMC member must be an evangelist. Okay? We have to bring others to CMC in order to meet Jesus Christ. Okay? So I hope at this time you are now ready to really have that personal relationship with the Lord. You know, at one time you were thinking that it was difficult for us. But at the end of the day, when me and my wife decided that we will be offering our lives to this community, you know, everything has changed. Everything has changed. Okay? So, it's a great privilege. It's a great privilege. This did not happen because of our hope. Okay? It is the Lord that allowed us to have this. It has happened by God's mercy and grace. So let's respond with gratitude and humility. Okay? Let's take the attitude of St. Paul. He said here in Philippians, whatever gains I have, these things I have come to consider a loss because of Christ. More than that, I even consider everything as a loss because of the supreme good of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord. For his sake, I have accepted the loss of all things, and I consider them so much rubbish that I may gain Christ. And imagine, if St. Paul was living today, what is he saying? My position in the office is not important. My career is not important. The money I'm earning is not important. They're all rubbish. It is not important to my life. What is important is gaining the life of Christ. Can you imagine that? Probably if he's not standing here, I'm listening, I'm saying, I don't think I will believe you, bro. No? It's difficult to really believe that. But that is what he's saying. This is nothing is important to him. More what is important to him is getting Christ to himself. But there's one thing I'm going to tell you, brothers and sisters, so that you will not be discouraged. I tell you, even if you feel that everything is not important, the Lord will give you many things to make you important. Even if you feel that having a high position is not important to you, if you believe and if the Lord thinks that you need to be there, he will give you a high position. If you don't even aspire for riches, if the Lord thinks that he needs you for his own good and glory, he will give it to you. And that's one thing that we have proven many ways. Believe, brothers and sisters. Many times we believe, many times most of us want to be, understand first to believe. Okay? I tell you, believe first and you will understand. Believe and you will understand. So, he also said, in all humility, I can really honor St. Paul means humility. It is not that I have already taken hold of it or have already attained perfect maturity, but I continue my pursuit in hope that I may possess it since I have lived in taken possession of Christ Jesus. Brothers, I for my part do not consider myself as taken possession. Just one thing. Forgetting what lies behind, but straining forward to what lies ahead. I continue my pursuit toward the goal, the prize of God's upward calling in Christ Jesus. You know, when sin, you know, even if St. Paul was chosen by Christ, he did not say that I am an important person. He did not even say that I am a chosen apostle of Christ. What did he say? I don't even possess that. Even if he has already possessed it. And that's the humility that's being asked from us, brothers and sisters. And so tonight, I hope that I have imparted some ahas, some learnings in this Christian program. It is the last of the talks. And hoping that once you come and join this community, that you really spend time to get this transformation in your life. I hope that you go and try to really live the life that was being taught us here. It really has changed many of us. Of course, this is not a perfect world. Some of us have, you know, gone astray. But when you have come back, and when you have stayed, you probably really have changed your life. And I hope that this may be something that you will want to put in your life. It has changed our lives, you know, our children. They're all grown up. We did not even have to get them, do not go out tonight, no. We just let them be. And I tell you, we have very obedient, and we have very kind children. They grew up very normal. They disco, they go to disco, they party, they drink. They're normal people. I'm not saying that they're not. But they have learned from us, even without telling them, the way that Christ wants us to be. And I hope when you go home tonight, brothers and sisters, you will come back and be part of this community. And many times that you are able to come here, you'll be able to bring others to really hear the word of the Lord. And someday you'll also be evangelizers and teachers of God. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, so tonight, brothers and sisters, we will not ask you to have your discussion. We will have what we call a dedication ceremony. Okay? Now, this dedication ceremony is like you have finished the CLP, we want to offer you to God. Okay. So, what are we going to do in this dedication ceremony? What we will do is like this. Eventually we will have you to read your covenant. What is this covenant? A covenant is your agreement with the Lord. Okay. The Corpus for Christ have what we call a covenant card. I will show you my covenant card. This is my covenant card. Sorry, it became very dirty because it's already 23 years with me. I have not lost this card. I think you have your covenant card in your eye. Can you take a look? Is it there? It's not. Oh, it's not. Okay, so it's not given. But never mind. I think that they prepared it there. So you will just read it. You know this card? This is what I always look at when I fail to do my mission here for Corpus. So I get myself to the end. I signed this 23 years ago. There is a funny story here. One time, many years ago, I told the Lord, Lord, I think I'm spending so much money. I have so many debt in the bank. Please help me. You know what he did? My God, you know, you really be amazed with the Lord. You know, I have a separate, I normally carry a separate wallet. This is where I put all my credit cards. And this is where my covenant card was placed. One day, I said, why don't I transfer my covenant card in my wallet? So I did. I transferred it in my wallet. This wallet is not 23 years. So every time I replace my wallet, I put it there. You know, after I replace it, you won't believe me. I lost all of my credit cards. All. So that was his answer to my prayer. Oh, you've been spending so much, I will confiscate all your credit cards. So, see, for many months, I was waiting for the replacement. I was not spending. So the Lord answers you in many, many different ways. Amen. So what we'll do is, I will ask you to stand up. I will, no, wait. Don't stand up here. You can stand up. I'll ask you to stand up. We will sing a song. Okay, then after that, all of you sit down. One by one, so members of those that are in Compass for Christ, we will ask you to stand up. Then Brother Mandy will lead you to recite in the covenant. Then we'll call the Admins of the Lord. Mr. Malin will lead you to lead in the covenant. Are there servants of the Lord here now? Okay, so we will, no, participant. Okay, so we will, who can read the formula? Who is now a member of, okay, you'll be the one. What's your name, bro?
Reggie.
Okay, I'll call you Brother Reggie. And finally, the Singles for Christ. I will call Brother Paolo to read that. Okay, then, after that, we will pray over you. Okay, then after the pray over, we will have our little praise fest, and then we will have some sharing, and then the beginning of new life, of your new life, in our life. Amen? Okay, so can I now invite everybody to start? Heavenly Father, we just praise and thank you for this evening, and thank you for just allowing our brothers and sisters to find their way here tonight with us. We praise and thank you, Lord, for just loving us, and for just allowing us, Lord, to have a renewed life in this community. We praise and thank you, Lord, for the brothers and sisters that you have invited, that you have called here, Lord. And we pray, Lord, that as we offer them to you tonight, we ask that you just continue to bless them, Lord. Watch them, dear Lord. They have come here for the past 12 weeks, dear God, hoping to find you, dear Lord. And I hope you have really touched their hearts, dear God. Lord, I know that it was difficult on the start. Some probably are having a difficult time to accept. But I know, Lord, that at this time, they are ready. They are ready to offer you that, Jesus. And so we offer to you this song, dear God, as we offer them and dedicate them to you, Heavenly Father.
15 minutes
participate regularly in the worship life of my church, avoid sin and wrongdoing, put God's order, good order into my private life. I dedicate myself to the task of building a strong family for Christ. Seek regular weekly dialogue with my spouse, my children. Exercise my duties actively as a parent. Pray with my family daily and celebrate the Lord's Day together. Invest generous amounts of time for home and family. I will make myself available to the Lord for service. Bring other couples to Christ. Make time to serve in couples for Christ whenever I am called to serve. And follow the directions of those who have responsibility for my service. I will relate in love and loyalty to other families in couples for Christ. Attend my small group meetings weekly and support the good order of the meeting. Faithfully attend all other meetings. Accept other couples whom the Lord adds to our number. I shall study and seek to grow as a Christian person and in understanding and fulfillment of my various vocations. Attend all contests, retreats, workshops, and conferences of couples for Christ. Diligently study all materials given to me. May our Lord Jesus Christ help me to be the covenant of the couples for Christ every day for his greater honor and glory and for the good of my brothers and sisters.
Okay, thank you, Brother Mati. Now the couples for Christ now can sit down. Can I now call Sister Madine to lead the handmaids?
And let's read the covenant together. Trusting in behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to thy word. Trusting in the Lord's help and guidance, I shall live as a follower of Christ. Pray and read scripture every day. Avoid sin and situations which can lead to sin. Put good order in my private life. And take responsibility for those who depend on me for support in their Christian life. Participate regularly in the worship life of my church. I will be a committed and active member of TSC and make the donation. And support the order of the meeting. Faithfully participate in all the activities of the group. I will remain in love, loyalty and respect to all sisters in the body. Intercede daily for the group and its mission. I will make myself available to the service, to the Lord for service. Bring other women to the handmaids of the Lord. I will give the work of Apostle for Christ and his ministry. I shall study and seek to grow as a woman of God. Attend all courses, retreats, workshops, and conferences of the TSC Handmaids of the Lord. Diligently study all materials given to me. May the Lord Jesus Christ help me to be a faithful in living out his commitment every day for his greater honor and glory and for the good of my people.
Thank you, Sister Malin. Okay, so the hand itself can sit down. How about the servant of the Lord, Brother Reggie?
Trusting the Lord's help and guidance. I would live as a follower of Christ, pray and read scriptures every day, avoid sin and situations which can lead to sin. Put good order to my private life and take responsibility for those who depend on me for support in their Christian life. Participate regularly in the worship life of my church. I will be a committed and active a member of CFC Servants of the Lord. Attend my small group meetings regularly and support the good order of the meeting. Faithfully participate in all activities of the group. Relate in love, loyalty, and respect to all brothers in the body. I will make myself available to the Lord for service, bring other men to the cause for Christ and its ministry, give generously of my time and resources to the Lord's service, support the works of Couples for Christ and its ministries. I will seek and grow as a man of God, attend all courses, retreats, workshops, conferences of the CFC servants of the Lord, diligently study all materials given to me. May the Lord Jesus Christ help me to be faithful in living out this commitment every day for greater honor and glory and for the good of my brothers.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, brother. Now can I call the singles for Christ? Brother Paul.
Okay, all singles for Christ, let's read this covenant together. Trusting in the Lord's help and guidance, I shall live by the power of Christ. Pray daily for at least 15 minutes. Read scriptures daily for at least 15 minutes. Live a righteous life and avoid situations which are occasions for sin. Put good order into my private life. Support my parents in building a Christian family. Participate regularly in the worship life of my church. I will work towards evangelization and transformation of my workplace, my family, and my community. Put good order in my work situation. Be a witness to the love and power of the Lord Jesus. My work and my family. Be a good steward of all resources entrusted to me. Be a good citizen of my country, obeying its laws and protecting its environment. I will be a committed and active member of CSCCLP's work for us. Attend my small group meetings regularly and support the good order of the meetings. Faithfully participate in all activities of the group. Relate in love, loyalty, and respect for all brothers and sisters of the Lord. Introduce me to the group of his nations. I will make myself available to the Lord for service. Bring other single men and women to Christ. Give generously of my time and resources to the Lord's service. Whenever I am called, and follow the directions of those who are responsibility for my service. Support the work of Apostles for Christ and his ministry. I will study and seek to grow as a Christian person. Attend all teachings, retreats, seminars, and conferences as a CFC in work for Christ. Diligently study all the materials given to me. May the Lord Jesus Christ help me to be faithful in living out his commitment and every day for greater honor and glory and for the glory of my brothers and sisters.
Okay. Thank you. So now, brothers and sisters, can I not only to gather to pray over all of our new brothers and sisters, please come fill this corridor with leader. Please come before all participants as well. I'm recording the corridor. Heavenly Father, once again we come before you and pray. We praise and thank you, Lord, for all these brothers and sisters that you have given us. Lord, with their own free will, they came here to Lord. We ask now, Heavenly Father, that you now start calling them by name. We ask you, Lord, that we strike them in the palm of your hands, Heavenly Father. Protect them. Keep them in your care and mercy, dear Lord. Allow them, Lord, to always be able to focus on your face, dear God. May they see you always in their workplace. May they see you in the things that they do, dear Lord. May they see you, Lord, in people even they don't know. May they see you, Lord, in all the joy and happiness that they see and witness and experience every day. May they see you, Lord, in every difficulties and trials that they face and encounter. May they call upon you, Lord, during the times that they are happy. Allow them to always be thankful praying. Allow them to pray with thanksgiving. And allow them, Lord, to always be helped by you, Lord, in times of their distress and difficulties. Always open the gates of heaven for them, Lord, especially when they're sick. Touch them, especially when they're having a difficult time, or whatever things that they want to do. Allow them, dear Father, to understand what we have taught them. Allow them, dear Lord, that through you, everything will happen as they desire. And thank you, dear Lord, for giving them to us, our new brothers and sisters, and for giving us to them, dear Lord, their new brothers and sisters. Allow the Holy Spirit to empower them, dear God, and pour a new fresh on them, dear God. Pour a new fresh on them, dear Lord.
Spirit of the living God.
Welcome, brothers and sisters.
Thank you.
brothers and sisters.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. I'm used to talk I love to talk. Thank God that we completed the 12 positions, and it's very, 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 very good. Because there were so many times that we want to miss the position, but then because of God's plan, and we are planning this to join in the community for how many years? We think for this time. I see that the couple of guys in the community, the people around us here, are very supportive. And attending the therapy, I learned so many things. And that's why I want to join this community, because I believe I can learn more and it's really great. So thank you very much. That's all.
Thank you. And one more brother Eric.
before I started attending this community meeting, me and my girlfriend, for myself, I have a experience going to the media before. So, being here is a really great experience. On the first talks that I attended, before I'm wondering where did all those speakers get their knowledge and the skills maybe to speak in front of many people and to give the shares based on their personal experiences and what really encouraging them to say whatever they want to share and to heard any other things that they want to give to all the participants. And in the near future, in God's grace, I can do it also.
Thank you, brother. So anyone from the house base of the Lord?
I have been ministering in church choir, but still I felt that there's still something missing. I felt that I need to do something else. Then one day my housemate, we just told me, she calls me Ina, or something like that. In this community, I found something very special. I felt very welcome and felt so warm, and most especially, I felt spirit coming back to me. And I got to be bantered with what I've seen with the activities that we have planned. I felt that I would be able to do what I want to be. Hopefully, I will be able to serve more of this community.
We're so blessed that God is good. that we have, that God called us again. Not in CFC, because just like Brother Bobby, I've been a speaker here, I've been in the community way back 1991. Imagine that. 1991. Started as a CFC, Young Adults Program. Then it was transitioned to the CFC, Youth for Christ. I'm one of the pioneers. So I was so blessed, and I was told again, 1997, Singles for Christ. Then I came here in Singapore, 2004. For 9 years, I hibernate. That's what the difficult part that happened in our lives, my wife and myself. Actually, my wife, she didn't ask, she's a Youth for Christ also. She's a Singles for Christ also. And both of us, nung kami nagkakilala, given is being my God's gift, deserving the anko gawad kalina. This is the volunteer. So, as you can see, our transition, that's why the community of CFC is no longer new for me. But I was so blessed, and I was looking for it, nung magpunta kami dito sa Singapore. So, for 9 years, it's been a struggle. In 9 years, there is really God's plan for us. So many brothers and sisters invited us here to serve again. But only now, the last 12 weeks that we've been here, was so amazing. We're always sitting at the back seat because of our child. As you can see, he's walking, he's here, the boy. For that 12 weeks that we have been here, we're always been struck, always been touched, always been blessed. That's why it's all shout out to me, my DLG. DGL. Quite new to the CLP head and to the service team that's always been here to support us. And also to the participants. Whenever we always see participants, we're always talking to my wife and kakauti tayo or marami tayo. Brothers and sisters, you always been the strength for us, for the two of us. Because always we see a lot of participants when can't attend and attend and nothing. That's why it's not about being here as couples for Christ now. I'm so proud of that. Actually, I shout out to my parents also. Because not for them, I'll not be here also. Because my parents also started in Couples for Christ way back 1989. So, probably they're so happy. Probably they're doing fellowship now upstairs. In heaven. Because my father and mother have already been there. So, they're Couples for Christ. Now I'm a Couples for Christ member. So, I'm so proud of, and I'm so blessed, and I'd like to introduce you my God's gift.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. Thank you so much for all of you. Talaga, bow ako sa inyo. Service team, sobra pong, napaka-blessed namin that we were invited po. I'll just give you a short. Pwede po ba akong mag-Tagalog? When Jojo and I met, we met at Gawad Kalinga Center, doon po sa site ng Gawad Kalinga, relocation site siya. May table po doon, nakaupo po ako sa chair, may ginagawa kaming paperwork. pinakilala po siya sa akin ng full-time worker namin. Nung kuya po ang tawag ko sa kanya. Kasi, kuya, kaya yung mga singles, kuya, pero eventually, nawawala rin yung kuya. Kuya sa umpisa. Nung nawala rin yung kuya, tuwa-tuwa siya. Kasi finally, nawala rin yung kuya. After yung journey namin together, has been very blessed. We've been together, as yung nasabi na nga po niya, we've been together for since 2004. 2004 pa po kami nandito. At yung pag-hibernate po namin, nakabuo po kami ng dalawang baby. I praise God po. At yung isa po baby namin, yun yung worry ko. Nung invite kami dito ni na Sister Mega and Brother Randy, ang isa ko po concern ay yung baby namin. Kasi hindi siya makontain sa isang place lang. So, nag-pray ako kay God, paano ko wag gagawin ko. Pero yung, alam niyo yung may something na nagpo-pull back sa akin. No, you will just go around, you cannot sit down and just, you cannot listen to the talk, you cannot do anything. Parang ganon. So parang, praise God, alam niyo kung bakit? Pamula nung talk one, siya ay kulot. Gigising siya, pagkain na lang. Ano ba ang gawin ng galing niya? Pag sinabi ni God na go, go! Huwag ka mag-worry. Sabi niya go, ay di go. Diba? Ganun ka ba yun si God? Napakasimpleng bagay, pero nakikita mo yung faithfulness niya sa atin. Kahit na kung iisipin natin sa sarili natin that we are just, alam mo yung kanina nakasulat doon, we are garbage from the past na tayo ay pira-pira po, na unti-unti niya tayong binubuo sa pamamagitan ng mga taong nakikita natin. Ako, I found myself na nabubuo sa Gawad Galinga. Nung pumasok ako sa Gawad Galinga, talagang pira-pira so ako. Sabi ko sa inyo, ako ay garbage. That's what I call myself. Pero every time that the kids go to me and call me ate, ate, ate Reggie, alam niyo yung spirit nila na binubuo nila ako uti-uti. Para siyang puzzle na uti-uting binubuo. Ganun yung nangyari sa akin. So yung transformation ko from Gawad Galinga hanggang sa bumalik kami dito, hanggang sa nakasama ko si Honey dito, hanggang sa nagkaroon kami ng mga baby, hanggang sa nakasama namin kayo ulit, ako po ay tuwang-tuwa. Deep in my heart, I really thank God that this moment I'm standing here. Ayan. Siya po ang best friend ng anak ko. Ayan, thank you so much po sa inyo lahat. Maraming pong salamat pa. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Brother Joe and Sister Regina. Okay, so I know that if not all, most of you would like to come forward tonight to share your blessings, you know, for the past 1 week. But unfortunately, given the time constraints, we will continue that next week. Don't worry, brothers and sisters. Okay, amen. Okay, so for the continuation of our program, allow me to pass on the microphone to our, you can see him, our unit head, who is leading us throughout this Christian Life program in the Blessed Sacrament. He will lead us for the meeting place prayer before we do our closing for tonight. Brothers and sisters,
Are you here?
Yes!
Parang yun na lang nakikita na narinig ko. Are you here?
Yes!
Are we all blessed tonight?